Hi. Now, let us carry on with the lead compensation design procedure. In the first step, we are going to find the bandwidth frequency, omega bandwidth, to meet the speed requirements. What are they? Settling time, rise time, delay time, or peak time. They are all related to measuring the speed of the response. So if you remember, we established such a relationship between the settling time, omega bandwidth, or peak time and omega bandwidth. Okay, so from here, from the requirement of settling time or peak time, and also from percent overshoot, we get the value of zeta, required percent overshoot gives us the zeta, and together with settling time and zeta, or peak time and zeta, will give us the omega bandwidth. Okay, in the second step, we are going to set the value of gain so that it satisfies the steady state error requirements. You know that all designs, all compensator or controller designs start with P control. P control means, I keep telling you this, P control is adjusting the gain. So we again start with P control, select a K, a value of K, so that we meet the steady state requirement. And for this selected gain values, we plot for the magnitude and phase diagrams and determine the systems. It is still uncompensated. Well, only gain adjusted system. Its phase margin can be measured from the Bode magnitude and phase plots. Okay, after plotting the Bode magnitude and phase diagrams, we will find phase margin to meet the damping ratio or percent overshoot requirement. I'm sure you will remember we had a relationship between the phase margin phi m or pm, okay, and zeta, damping ratio. You know that zeta and percent overshoot are directly related. They are inversely and logarithmically proportional. So from damping ratio or percent overshoot requirement, we will determine phase margin, okay? Then evaluate the additional phase contribution required from the compensator. Most probably, the phase margin of the uncompensated system will not be large enough to satisfy the percent overshoot requirement. Suppose that the PM1 is phase margin of the uncompensated system, just gain adjusted uncompensated system, and PM2 is the required phase margin to provide the satisfaction of percent overshoot. The difference between these PM2 minus PM1, okay, will give us a phase angle, maximum phase angle, so that the compensator should do or will do its job for the requirement of percent overshoot. Again, we are going to add another 10 degrees, around 10 degrees, 5 to 12 degrees, to compensate for the, look at here, it initially the phase plots of lead compensator, initially they are so low, and the system to be compensated has also initially a low phase angle. So in order to compensate for this, we add another 10 degrees. Okay, now in the next step, step five, we are determining the value of beta. From where? From phi max. If you remember, where was that expression? Here it is. Together with you, we obtained this equation. So if we know phi max from step four, we can easily obtain the value of beta. And the, in the next step, we are going to determine compensator's magnitude at the peak of the phase curve. What is it? What was that formula? The maximum value of lead compensator's magnitude when omega is omega max was found as, where was it? Here, 1/, it is just 1/ square root beta. 1/ square root beta. So we know beta from here. In six, we will determine the maximum value of magnitude that will be contributed by the lead compensator. And look at this step seven. Determine the new phase margin frequency. Determine the new phase margin frequency, which is also called gain crossover frequency, by finding where the uncompensated system's magnitude curve is the negative of the lead compensator's magnitude at the peak of the compensator's phase curve. It is such a long sentence, but it basically tells us we specified omega pm before by means of phi max, okay? At that phase angle, determine the magnitude value, all right? From where negative magnitude, from the magnitude curve, and take its negative so that this value will be compensated by omega max. The magnitude, maximum magnitude. Okay, we will see this in the example. Step eight, design the lead compensator's break frequencies using these 11.6 and 11.9. 11.6 and 11.9, this is the general expression for the lead compensator, we know this. And this is omega max. Omega max is 1/ t square root beta. Here it is. I scribbled it here. We know omega max, okay. We specified omega max here. Omega pm is now omega max, because at that frequency, we provide the maximum phase and magnitude. So from here, we know omega max, we know the value of beta, we can determine t. Okay, so we can find t. Well, if you know beta, right here, if you know beta, if you know t, look at here, your lead compensator is determined. The transfer function is determined. So you are completing the design. Just look at this step. Reset the system gain to compensate for the lead compensator's design. Yeah, this is the one. Since we are multiplying the transfer function with 1 over beta, this makes the gain at low frequencies 1, which means 0. It comes with 0 decibel. So it is done. And in the step 10, check the we plotted the complete body diagram. You know, consisted, it is a cascaded system now. The controller, the lead compensator, and the system, the plant, to be controlled, to be compensated with feedback. Now, from their open loop body diagram, you can estimate, if you remember from the previous chapter, there was a relationship between the open loop frequency response and closed loop frequency response. In any way, either from the open loop or from more precisely closed loop, you check the bandwidth frequency and see if the requirement, if the speed requirement is satisfied. Then simulate to see all the requirements are met. If not, redesign the compensator, you know, by getting through all those steps. Now, let us make use of these steps. Let us make use of this procedure to do this numerical example. Let us take a short break. Now, let us study this example, which is the like the case study we took. It is a position control system. The transfer function is g of s 100 times k, 100 times k over s times s plus 36 times s plus 100. Now, what are the requirements? Given the system, design a lead compensator, to yield a 20% overshoot and KV of 40 with a peak time of 0.1 seconds. Now, let us save time. As you know, 20% overshoot with that logarithmic equation, you get the damping ratio of 0.456, and this will give us a peak time of 0.1. And omega bandwidth, I just pasted here the figure. I used this when I explained the bandwidth concept. It is very important, you know, because look at here, the bandwidth frequency is here, okay? It corresponds to the magnitude, right, which is below 3 decibel of its magnitude in its low frequencies. So why is it so important? This 3 decibel, okay, is minus 3 decibel, all right, minus 3 decibel, corresponds to 1 over square root 2, which is 0.707, right? 707, and the since it is the power is a quadratic expression, what is the square of this 0.49, which is around 50%. So that means after this frequency, less than 50% of the power is transferred. So we never want that. So we have to work within this range, within from low frequencies to the bandwidth frequency. Anyway, it is also directly related to the, as I reminded you here, directly related to the speed of the response. Okay, where is the problem here? We know peak time as 0.1 and percent overshoot from the required damping ratio from the required percent overshoot. So omega bandwidth can be found, the required omega bandwidth can be found 46.6 radian per second. Then maybe we should follow those steps. In step one, we determined omega bandwidth. In step two, we are going to determine the value of k. So limit s as approaches to zero, s times g of s gives us kv, right? Kv, which is required to be 40, right? So here, let us carry on with another color here. Limit s goes to zero, 100 k over, there is an s here, s times s plus 36 times s plus 100 equals 40, right? So these s's will be simplified. S goes to zero, 100 and 100 will be simplified. So the k to satisfy the steady state error requirement would be 36 times 40, which is this 1440, isn't it? Yes. And the damping ratio, let us follow the steps, okay? In step three, we can have, or we can draw the Bode plots. I can show it here, okay? Bode plots, which are obtained, Bode magnitude and phase plots, which are obtained for k equals 1440. Okay, so what is the phase margin here? Okay, this is the magnitude, this is the phase. Where is the crossover frequency here? When the gain is zero, right? And then go down, okay? This difference is the PM of the uncompensated system. You can say PM1, which is something around, if this is, I don't know, 100 and minus 140 something, around 40, less than 40, it is 34.1. Okay, so from here, PM old is, or PM, what did we say? PM1 is 34.1. What about the damping ratio, okay, required for percent overshoot, okay? In order to satisfy this zeta, PM2, using this formula here, that there's a direct relationship between the phase margin and damping ratio. So from here, PM2 2 is 48.1. 48.1. Okay, so the contribution, okay, the contribution expected from the lead compensator must be from 34 to 48. Well, 48 minus 34, 14 degrees. Let us add another 10 degrees to compensate for those low phase degrees at low frequencies, right? It is 24 degrees. So the maximum phase angle, okay, provided by the lead compensator must be 24 degrees. So this is step three. I don't want to miss the steps. Okay. So in this is step three, body plots and determining this and determining 24 degrees four. And in step five, what does step five find beta from where? From phi max. What is the formula? This phi max equals, right? Phi max equals inverse sine, right? Inverse sine 1 minus beta over 1 plus beta. Take sine of both sides, sine phi max equals 1 minus beta plus over 1 plus beta. This is sine of 24 degrees. Okay, so it is just an equation with one unknown. Beta, the value of beta is found as I did solve this problem, so it is you can trust 0.42. Okay, this is five. Now let us find quickly the magnitude value for omega max, the peak value, what was the formula for this? Here it is, 1 over square root. This one I scribbled here as well, 1 over square root beta gives us, where is it? I don't know. Let me solve it here. Beta is 0.42. Okay. Beta is 0.42, and g 1 over square root beta is 1.543. 1.543. In decibel, this would make 20 log 1.54 makes 3.77 decibel. Okay. Well, In fact, if you remember the seven, step seven, take the negative y, the logic is here, look at here. It says, determine the new phase margin frequency, nu omega pm, by finding where the uncompensated system's magnitude curve is the negative of the lead compensator's magnitude at the peak of the compensator phase curve. It's complicated, but not 3.77 decibel has to be lowered to zero decibel. So a 3.77 decibel contribution is needed. So if you look at here, at this point, 3.77 must be here, okay? Must be here. What is the frequency at that time? 39 radian per second. So this is omega max is 39 radian per second. It should be written somewhere here. Okay, here, look. Then we can, by means of this omega max equals 1 over t, okay, square root beta. You know omega max, you know beta. From here, we can find t as 0.04. Isn't it great? We know beta, okay, we know beta. Let me change color. We know beta, we know t. That means we can design our lead compensator. So lead compensator, Gc of s, will be 1 over beta. 0.42, okay. 0.42 times s plus 1 over t, 0.04 over s plus 1 over 0.04 times 0.42, which makes this. Okay, so this is the lead compensator just that we just designed. So you are just combining this lead compensator with the plant because they are connected, cascaded. Okay. Now, I think we designed, we finished the problem. It is now time to check the bandwidth to be sure the speed requirement in step one has been met. Now, I don't know if you remember, there was a good relationship, actually, Nichols' chart showed us. Nichols' chart, as you remember, Nichols' chart establishes a relationship between the open loop body magnitudes and closed loop body magnitudes. According to, if you remember, according to that, if or when the phase angle is between minus 135 and minus 225 degrees, when phase angle is around this, if the magnitude is okay, if the magnitude is somewhere around minus 6 to minus 7.5 decibel, okay. At this time, the omega is, in fact, omega bandwidth, because this is coming from where the magnitude in the closed loop is minus 3 decibel. So it is the bandwidth frequency of the closed loop system. Now, if you look at here, at around minus 7, minus 7.5 here, here somewhere. Okay. Choose this at minus 7, if you go like this, okay. It is around, I don't know, according to the book, it is around 70. It is around, well, this is 10 anyway, 20, 40, 50, so around 70, right? So it's the omega bandwidth is around 70 radian per second, if you can read this Fourier the magnitude plot carefully, all right? This is, if you compare this value with the required omega bandwidth, we specified at one, number one, okay? What was it? What was the value of omega bandwidth? 46.6 radian per second, which is, you know, smaller than the actual omega bandwidth. That means the settling time or peak time, is, I mean the speed parameters are satisfied. How about the percent overshoot? If you check this percent overshoot value, you will see that, I want to save time, 2-3% exceeds the required percent overshoot. It is around 22.5%, whereas the required percent overshoot was only 20%, right? This could be either tolerated, okay, or you know, that 10 degrees we added just in case. We can play with it, you know, to get a better phase margin, which is directly related to the percent overshoot. So the so that the percent overshoot requirement can be satisfied. Okay, I'll stop here. I can present you a couple of more examples, but let me post those examples to you in PDF format. This is the end of lead compensation design. I will try to make another video on leg lead design if time allows. Okay then, take care, bye-bye.